Hi, my name is Jason Kang. I'm a full-stack developer working in South Korea. We have built the header of our blog so far. But let's say you want to see what it looks like on the Chrome browser. Or you actually might want to share the progress with your friends or family or colleagues. So even though we have not finished cloning Medium, I thought it might be good for us to deploy our project. Deploying a project means to make it accessible by the public, which means anyone with a link can access what you have built. I have talked about how cloud is more convenient, accessible, and reliable than physical devices. For example, if you're to follow this on your own with a physical device, that means you have to purchase a computer, wait for it to ship to your office or your home, and then set this up. But if you use cloud, that means you can just simply do it by clicking some buttons. And today we're going to use NAVER Cloud Platform to deploy our project. Let's go to NAVER Cloud Platform first. If you haven't, please sign up and then log in. Let's go straight to the console. And let's go to server. You can see that I have two servers running already because I use NAVER Cloud for my personal projects. But today I'm going to show you how to use VPC. VPC stands for Virtual Private Cloud. You are granted with a private cloud of your own, which is completely isolated from other organizations or users. It's like having a space of your own. And NAVER Cloud Platform offers VPC in Korea and Singapore, and it will expand to other regions like Japan pretty soon. And I'll talk about VPC in detail later on. So let's go back to the console and click VPC, set up our server. And let's click Create Server. Let's go Ubuntu. Well, I created VPC in subnet before, so I can use this, but I'm going to show you how to create it just for your own sake. Let's go to Create VPC. And then you can choose one of the three IP ranges. I'm just going to use the last one. And then it's going to start running and creating. And then you also have to create a subnet associated with the VPC. Let's create a subnet. And then address range. And then use those VPC and subnet to create the server. So after creating the VPC and subnet, let's refresh this page. And then we'll click Ubuntu. And then choose the VPC and subnet we just created. There we go. And then we don't need that big of a server because it's a very simple project. So I'm going to use standard and go with a smaller size. Server name would be code.blog. And then allow this to auto allocate the IPs. And then I'll set a public IP later on. Let's just create a new one, just for demo's sake. Then we'll save it. ACG, default. And then create server. It's gonna take a while to create and boot and configure the server, so I'm gonna use the server that I created before to show you how to deploy your project. The first thing you gotta do is assign public IPs and open ports. It's been already assigned, but I'm gonna show you how to do it. So you go to public IP in your console and click this. Let me just deassociate it to show you how to use it. And now that it's operating, I can assign this IP or associate this IP with my server. Let's click this. There we go, setting. And then meanwhile, we'll go to the ACG, which is Access Control Group, and open ports. Oh, it's operating. It's this one. If you see, I've opened port 22 to access my server, and port 80, which is the default port or standard port for HTTP request. That port 80 is gonna be used to access the blog that we created. So let's go. So with this, if you remember the key that I created, I'm going to use the key to get the admin password. So go to get admin password, code on medium clone, and then get admin password. There we go. And then we're going to use a terminal and SSH to access the server. So let's open up the terminal. Now I'm going to access the server from the terminal using the public IP we just created. And that's it for today. And as always, if you want to learn something specific, please leave them in the comments below so I can answer your questions. Thank you and stay tuned.